Greetings of the day, Healthwire Media viewers. This side your host, Vaibhav Bhatra. And today we are talking about a very interesting topic for our interview. As we all know that losing weight is not easy and losing belly fat is even more difficult. And we are sure you have tried everything from that fancy diets and that hardcore workout. But what if you just still can't lose weight, especially the belly fat? And to address this problem, we have requested a very special guest to join us today and take our questions related to weight loss, healthy diet, and much more. So I'd like to welcome Dr. Sukeshneri Ramtike, diet consultant, sports physiotherapist, and fitness influencer at Access Hospital, Mumbai. Welcome, ma'am, to our show.
Thank you so much for having me here. Hello, yes, all.
Yes, ma'am. So, ma'am, as we all know that most women in our inbox that have messaged us that we have tried everything, so homemade food, we have tried every diet. So, we are not able to, you know, reduce our weight, lose weight. So what are the things that they should include in their diet and any diet plan you can suggest which they can easily follow for good results?
Before talking about diet, I would like to tell you something about the cause of obesity. Like if someone is getting or putting on weight, so there are so many reasons of that. Like one could be the overeating, as you said, that then the diet part is the important part. But there are other reasons also, like if the female is having difficulty during menstrual cycle, or it might be because of slowing down of metabolism. And then if the sleeping cycle is not proper, or if the person is having any stress or anxiety or depression, and it also depends on the physical activity throughout the day. It depends on your routine. It depends on your job profile. Everything contributes to gaining weight. So one should know the cause first for that. And then apart from that, as far as diet concerned, so the person can have a very balanced diet. Like start a day with the normal lukewarm water first, and then start with the very healthy breakfast, including some fruits and some raw food like sprouts. They can have then having a protein in the diet is very much important, because that would help with increasing metabolism, and it is easy to digest. And then having buttermilk before meal, that will reduce the appetite, and so that the person can consume less amount of food. So yeah, that small thing would help in reducing diet, reducing weight.
And ma'am, there are also like weight reducing products in the market, many products there are. So is it safe to go for these options if one is not able to lose weight or something?
So for a limited, if person is using it for a limited period of time, then it's okay. But according to in my opinion, I would suggest any product like capsule or supplement, because everything is having their own disadvantage also. So getting it loose naturally is always good, because the thing which have a instant result cannot sustain longer. And weight loss is something which you need to be longer, for the longer period of time, or for the permanently, you can say. So getting it done naturally is always good. So yes, keeping a track on your diet and doing some physical activity, having good amount of water intake, that would help in reducing weight rather than using those supplements or capsules.
And also that many women are more vulnerable to the thyroid problem, which directly impacts their weight metabolism and other things. So what are the diet and special things they should keep in mind, like the women especially who have the thyroid problems?
Thyroid problem, mostly females are more vulnerable for the thyroid problem compared to me. The reason is not known yet, but yes, females are having so many hormonal changes throughout the life, start with the puberty, then comes the reproductive age, then comes menopause, in between there is a pregnancy. So there are second time when females have to face so many changes physically and emotionally, mentally also. So there are two types of thyroid issues, like hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism. So in case of hyperthyroidism, there is increase of T3, T4 secretion. So to control that, you should have like non-iodized salt, and you can have egg white, then fresh vegetables, then vegetables like broccoli and cauliflower that will help in enhancing the metabolic rate. Then comes red meat and green leafy vegetables. And talking about hypothyroidism, in which the secretion is less, so the diet which includes a good amount of minerals like selenium and zinc is more recommended, because selenium is like activate the thyroid hormone, and zinc is associated with the regulation of thyroid stimulating hormone. So tea, meat, and some poultry products like chicken, that would help in controlling the weight gain because of this thyroid.
And ma'am, like there are many questions about the intermittent fasting, and people are, it is a new trend and people want to know more about it. So is it really help that intermittent fasting, and do you really suggest for losing weight this type of diet thing?
Yes, intermittent dieting is in the trend nowadays, and yes, it is helpful if it is getting done properly. There are different types of intermittent dieting. One is like 16 by 8, in which the person can have a first diet, like if he's having in around 12 o'clock, then first meal would be taken by 12 o'clock around, and then she would have a gap of long 8 hours, and then after 8 hours by 8 p.m. she can have another diet of a day, and then again she would have a long gap of 16 hours. So in between this 24 hours, she is having the 2 meals, having a long gap in between, which is like a fasting only. So including this gap, she can have a normal fruits and the things which you generally eat while fasting. Then another type is the 5:2, which goes with like a week, you can say. So like in a week, on day 2nd and 5th, you are eating a very very limited amount of calories, like you can say 600 calories for male and 500 calories for female, and the rest of the days you are eating normally. Then comes eat stop eat type of like a pattern of dieting, in which it is a cycle of 3 days, in which day one you are eating normally, and then on another day you would be on fasting for long period, like say for 24 hours, and then you would be having your next meal on day 3.
Okay, so it's an alternate cycle.
It would be the cycle of 3 days. So day one and day 3, you are eating normally, and in between the day 2nd, you are fasting for 24 hours.
Okay.
Then by day 4, you are then again start with your new cycle. Alternate day would be the another type of intermittent dieting, which would be like one day having food properly, and next day 24 hours gap. That is fasting for 24 hours, and then again, like odd day you are eating, and even days you are fasting for 24 hours. Then one more is the warrior diet, which is like people mostly follow, in which they are eating in the morning. They are having more like fibers containing food and fruits, and then they are keeping the gap for the some hours, like 6 to 8 hours. Then in the evening, they are having a high feast kind of diet, and then again they are fasting for the next day, and the cycle will repeat for every day. And so these are the types of intermittent dieting. Yes, it is helpful. Even it is helpful for diabetic people also, like type 2 diabetic people can follow this type of diet. Obviously they have to be like supervised if they are doing such things, but yes, it is helpful.
And ma'am, we have seen a culture like people want to lose weight for a special function or an occasion. Then they follow a diet routine. And after that, they start, you know, back to their normal lifestyle and start gaining weight again. So what is that type of diet trend is harmful or something for the, you know, people?
So your body needs time to adapt anything, whether you are dieting or you are doing any activity or not doing it. So that's why I only suggest a balanced diet which people can follow for lifetime. So eat healthy, eat properly on time. That would only I suggest, and only dieting is not going to help. So obviously you have to do some physical activity also. Have to one should have a good amount of sleep is also important, because that would relieve your stress and anxiety. So as for diet concern, I would suggest that it would be simple, like start your day with a 2 glass of lukewarm water or lemon water maybe. Then have a very healthy breakfast, including fruit or homemade breakfast, you can say, including Kuma types. And then have a heavy meal in afternoon, which includes chapati, rice, and green leafy vegetables. Compulsorily, green vegetables you should have in a day at least. Then one pulses should be there in your diet. Then at night, you can just have a light dinner, which includes either soup or you can have salad. And then, I mean, half of your diet, your meal will get replaced by soup or salad. Then that would be your light meal. So that because during night, you are not doing any activity. So it is difficult to digest if something heavy you are eating. So dinner should be lighter than lunch. Lunch you would have proper, and healthy food you should eat in morning. That is your first meal. So that thing, if I think everyone can follow this for lifetime, the patient or people won't have any difficulty in following those stuff, because there are no restrictions, right? So just have to eat healthy and on time. That's
Ma'am, and you know, there are many females who have just questioned us that PCOD and PCOS is a condition that affects a woman during their reproductive age, and many girls want to know that. Hello, am I audible, ma'am?
Yes.
So many girls want to know that what are the tips so that they can manage that PCOD and PCOS, the diet they should follow, and exercise, if any.
First, we should understand that what is the difference between PCOD and PCOS.
True.
So PCOD is a condition, it is not a disease. And 1/3 of the female population is having this kind of condition, in which there is an increased amount of the male hormone that is called androgen. And in that, there is a so many release of immature or partially mature eggs get released. And because of that, sometimes cysts are getting formed in the ovaries. But it is not harmful at all. It is not having any effect on your female fertility or something. So that can get and it affects it happening because of the your lifestyle you are carrying, your diet, and your physical activity, your level of stress, and everything. So if you'll have a control on those components, so obviously you can get deal with PCOD. But in case of PCOS, it is not the condition, it is a disease, in which again there is an imbalancement of the hormone androgen. But in this there is an interference with the formation of the release of ovum or the egg. So, so that egg is not getting released and it is not getting eliminated from the ovary. And that's why it is getting deposited in the ovary and ultimately getting converted into cyst. So this is a serious case. So in that case, obviously diet would be one part, but one should consult the gynecologist. And talking about diet, the female can have a natural diet which are high in fibers. Watery fruits she can have. Then fatty fish she can have. Spinach, mostly green, dark green leafy vegetables, then colored fruits like the grapes, berries, cherries, these all things, and then broccoli and cauliflower, obviously, because it is good for enhancing the metabolism. Then dried beans you can have, then nuts you can have, then dark chocolate also she can have with a very moderate amount. So that would help in dealing with this PCOD condition.
Okay, And ma'am, we all know that jaggery is very important, digestive component that one can, after dinner or after every meal that can consume and helps in digestion process. But for diabetic patients, that they have an habit that it is healthy, so we should consume it or something. But it has some amount of sugar. So is it safe for diabetic patients to have jaggery after their meal or something?
Jaggery, it is having very health benefits. Yes, it helps in weight reduction, especially reducing fat around your belly area. So yes, it is useful and obviously helps in increasing metabolism. So having a piece of jaggery after a meal would help in digestion. People are having problems with constipation or low metabolism can have jaggery. But in case of diabetic people, I won't suggest to have this because after all, it is the kind sugar. Of sugar, and any sugar from any source is obviously dangerous for the diabetic people. So because it is also having high glycemic index and it can spike the sugar level. So obviously it is not recommended for the diabetic people.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your time. It's a great having conversation with you. And our viewers are very happy that they get all the, you know, tips and, you know, what they should add in their diet so then they can lose weight and have a healthy work lifestyle. Because that's very important. Losing weight is a slow process, but having a healthy lifestyle is the first step they can take.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am.